All right. Yes, finish. Vivian's still doing it.
Yeah.
All right. So, real quickly, table right here. What was your messages?
Stand by the door and look really stressed.
Stand by the door and look really stressed. All right. How about you guys back here?
Skip around the room and look really stressed.
Skip around the room and look really stressed. William.
Stand.
Skip around the room. How about you guys over here?
Skip around the room and look really stressed.
Look really stressed. And how about over here?
Stand by the door and skip around the room.
Skip around the room. All right. So, real quickly, what was that like trying to figure that out?
Easy.
Pretty easy? What made it easy?
Once you get the first word, which is usually like in the middle, you kind of just make out what the rest of it is.
Okay, yeah, that makes a big deal. William.
I didn't understand it at all.
You don't understand it? Why? What made it hard?
I thought it was like, you have to say it, and then there was going to be like a mixed word situation. Like if I said new radio or something like that, it would have to sound like something else that I would know.
All right.
So I try to pronounce it like, what is this? Like I have no clue. And then,
right.
And then Douglas like used his brains and like mixed up.
Well, it can be a little confusing at first, right?
Yeah.
Like just looking at that, just seeing that, the way my brain works, I literally, if I look at that, I just get overwhelmed and like someone else has to figure this out. It's not going to be me. Michael, did you get your hand up to him?
Yeah.
Good.
I said the letters of the word, like the letters of the public together.
Yeah, and they do, because there's some leading clues. Do you have any other comments over here? So, when we do an activity like this, it's called mixed messages. And the reason why we did this, and what I liked is when Tania said it was really easy, and William said it was a little hard. Because when you guys think about the new marijuana laws, for some people, they look at that and like, all right, cool, this is easy. It's this, this, and this. And for sometimes when you look at it, it's like, whoa, what does this even mean? I don't know what this means. I don't know how this impacts me, whether it's my age, whether it's where I live, all these different things. There's a lot of factors into that, and we want to do mixed messages today because we want to help clear up some of those messages that you guys might be receiving. We hear a lot of kids saying, weed's legal, which means I can do X, Y, and Z. And that might not necessarily be true. So what we want to do, but the messages that people are getting out there, and I know I hear these messages all the time, oh, it's okay to do this now, it's okay to do that now, and there's all these types of misinformation that we want to kind of use to clear up today, and that's why we did this kind of activity. William, I see you in the back.
Even if it was legal, you'll have to be 21 years old.
Yeah, we're gonna get at that, William. So we're gonna start talking about some of those facts in just a minute. But that's
fault.
No, William, that's important that you know that. It's important that you know that, and it's important that other people know that. And that's one of the things we're gonna get at today. So what I'm gonna do now is, I'm actually gonna pass it on to Chuck, who's gonna run us through the game show. We're gonna do the game show about half an hour, then we're gonna have a little discussion about this, get some questions and answers out there, and we'll go from there. So, guys, welcome Chuck.
Welcome.
Yes,
Chuck.
Thank you,
James,
for a wonderful introduction. I'm joined here with Kalua, my partner in prevention. We're both Tufts interns working for Lovely Heller with Somerville Cares About Prevention. And a little bit about Somerville Cares About Prevention, or SCAP, like what we like to call it. It's a community-based prevention coalition that works to engage community members, especially the youth, to raise awareness around issues that you guys might face in the community, and just to typically, or just generally, create a more healthy community. So.
Yeah, so today we have an exciting game for you guys to play. You have your letters in front of you, so you're going to use that. And it's just to test our knowledge about marijuana and the recent legalization of the laws in Massachusetts. So, again, this activity is brought to you by SCAP and the City of Somerville, Somerville Health and Human Services Department, and, let's get started.
So, you guys are going to listen to the questions, hold up whichever, A, B, C, or D, and we can see how well you guys know the laws. So,
does everybody have letters?
Yes.
Okay, raise your hand if you don't.
Yeah, we all.
Oh.
All right, lovely. Sound lovely. First question, William. So, until you're 18 years of age, you can possess marijuana products. True or false?
Right,
overwhelmingly,
your original.
Not for me.
Oh,
I told you.
Yo,
tell
him
about the logic.
Tell him? I'd like to read it. You must be 21 years or older to have possession of marijuana and similar products. If caught, you can be reprimanded by law.
Which means
you have to go to court and then this and all that.
All that.
Except.
Next question. You're allowed to use
even though it is
legal. Next question. Is okay to drive on the
Yes.
We got one
I have to be right
inside.
Get you more focus.
That is false.
Oh.
It is still legal. If you're driving under the influence of marijuana, you will be charged with DUI or DWI. Face jail time and definitely lose your license. So don't do that, especially you guys just starting to get your license. All right. Marijuana is not as bad for you as alcohol or other substances.
I don't know.
Honestly, I don't know.
I definitely
think
heroin is
good. All right.
The plant.
Oh, what?
Alright, so there have been studies to show that marijuana actually is bad and definitely detrimental for your brain development, even if it's hard. So stay away. We need you guys to be smart. Next question.
William, how do you know this?
Because I'm a genius up in here.
That's right, you are, William.
Thank you so much.
So, despite popular belief, most kids don't use marijuana at school. But if you think a lot of your classmates do, a lot of them actually don't. Next question. How much more likely is a marijuana user to develop an addiction later in life?
I can't help it.
For sure.
All right.
Next question.
Oh, that on my God.
You can overdose on marijuana.
No.
Meaning you can die from So data shows that edibles are mainly responsible for an increase of ER visits. Marijuana overdoses, people tend to use more than a single serving due to packaging, which is often like that of candy and brownies and what have you.
Guys, the overdose doesn't mean someone died.
No.
Like, you know, so it could be they overdosed. They have to have a hospital visit, you know what I mean? It doesn't mean death.
It could.
It definitely could. But that's when it.
But this is based off me consuming an edible.
So I just want to make sure everyone's. Just so you guys are clear though,
right.
Like,
so
an overdose can be many things. I saw you guys react like no. But it could be if someone got really sick, like alcohol poisoning.
Because all the chemicals.
Or you could, you know, not to say that all this stuff can't happen. I just want to be clear on that.
THC.
Alright.
I'm like
Alright, so regular use of marijuana can have which of the following symptoms on people who
eat. Some people eat before stimulating.
Hey guys, we want to be able to hear the questions when they're reading them, so totally understand your reactions, but just remember when they start reading them again, refocus, reset, we're good.
Heavy users who quit smoking can have withdrawal like symptoms. Smoking marijuana can affect your ability to perform in school and work. True or false?
Wait.
Oh.
Yo.
You got a C over here.
It's either
oh,
this
why
or
am I the only C, bro?
Oh, there's the
B. Okay.
Oh,
okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. What is the main reason individuals begin using marijuana?
Or actually, yeah, me too.
Okay. A.
You
love
that
A.
You know what's gonna be all the above?
No.
Yes.
No. I need all of these less. Either just for your reasons. However, marijuana tends to make these issues worse. And long-term use is connected to anxiety and depression, as we learned yesterday. Alright, if you work in a state that legalized marijuana, can you still be drug tested when applying for jobs?
Sure.
Oh, what? Why am I?
Oh. Marijuana is still federally illegal, which means the United States does not condone the purchase, consumption, or distribution of marijuana products, especially for government funded agencies. Marijuana charges, like minor in possession, can cause you to lose financial aid, scholarships, and other funds that are hard to lose.
There we go.
Yeah.
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 No, B up there, you?
It's B, guys.
Let's put a C up. Let's put a C up. Oh,
a marijuana possession charge can affect one's ability to receive financial aid, funding, and scholarships because this drug is still federally illegal. Alright.
Thank you for playing.
Hey, wait, I got a question for you guys. What was the most surprising question you guys saw?
Overdose.
Not the 21 dope joke?
Overdose.
What you got, Will?
I think the one that is more effective than alcohol and, you know,
that
cigarettes.
Not bad for you.
Yeah, because, like, a lot of people say, oh, it's just a plant. Like, I mean, everyone was shook. I'm not the only one.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm like, wow.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.